Okay, we're looking at another case of another student's preparation. I was telling you that I could see the groove, the going through the central area. The ridge here is prominent and different and distinct from the groove here. So you have done that correctly. This groove and this ridge are also distinct. Now, the margin, if I go lingually, the same thing is present, so that's excellent. You have kept the morphology of the two, the original morphology of the two. My second critique is of the marginal ridge area. Here I find the marginal ridge open. Nothing is distracting me, okay? From going from this area to this area. It's totally open, totally flat. Good. But here I have like a step. I feel it with my tip of the thing, the pencil. I could feel that there's a small step, so you have to open it. The marginal ridge is opened. Regarding the central area, there's like a pebble here. You have not prepared it, just do that, okay? But the central groove is kept in the correct location. The buccal cusp is not going towards the lingual, and the lingual is not going towards the buccal. You have kept the proportions, because we know that the buccal is wider and the lingual are smaller. So you have kept those proportions. The buccal cusp is a bit larger from the lingual, but not very prominent, and you have not shifted the central groove area. So that's correct. Looking at it axially, if I look at it axially, I could see that you have two planes. I could see a plane here and a plane here. They are separate. Good. I could see that this ridge is separate from the central area. So I could feel that you're going with the anatomy of the tooth buccally. So that's correct. The same thing doesn't apply to the lingual. Can you see it? Lingually? It's almost flat, lingually. You don't go through the groove, because if I want to keep the preparation thickness, if I don't do this groove, now this groove is present originally, so that means if I don't do it and mimic it, that means the material here, the crown material here, will be very thin, or it will be over-bulging. Mm. If it over-bulges, what will happen? If the technician, if you have not created this central area a bit deeper than the ones on the side, the technician will give you the thickness of the material. It's one thickness on the axial wall. What will happen? It will be thicker here. What will happen? It will be over-bulging. What will happen if you over-bulge the tooth in the morphology of the crown? You will lose the massage of the gingiva, okay? The food will go away from the gingiva without any massage for the gingiva. You might lose the gingival thickness and the part of the attached gingiva thickness by like dystrophy, like muscle dystrophy. What happens? If you don't use the muscle, it will grow small. It will shrink and will not grow in size. So the same thing with the gingiva. If you don't keep massaging it, how does it massage naturally? SubhanAllah, that Allah made the morphology of the crown naturally to distract the food away, to have a food escape path, but it still touches the gingiva enough to massage it. So it's massaged, it's always touched and massaged, and the tissue, the blood vessels are always intact in this area, so the thickness will keep in place, okay? So this is the consequence if you don't do the central groove area. It's not a total groove, but it's following the morphology of the tooth. You have done it excellently here. Buccally, you have followed it, but lingually, you have not, okay? So I might suffer from the over-bulging of the crown later on, okay? Proximally, good. I could see there is the demarcation between the shoulder and the chamfer. I could see the groove here. It's like a ledge between a deep shoulder and the shallow chamfer. By the way, many students sometimes tell me, and this is the case of a previous case where they had done over preparation, they'll tell me, "Doctor, I've used the chamfer bare." It's not the bare that creates the chamfer, it's the depth that creates the chamfer. So even if you use a chamfer bare and you prepare more, it will go back into a step or a shoulder. So it doesn't matter what bare you were using. It is the depth in the axial wall that matters. So here you have created a good chamfer. There are no undercuts all around. I respect that. Did you touch then the adjacent tooth? Okay, I'll give you a mark for that. You have touched this tooth. I could see some roughness. And you have made this flat. You have lost the marginal. If you want to close up, do a close-up. This is flat now. You have touched it and even prepared it flat, as if it was a guide plane. It's not that, you should not touch adjacent teeth. So your preparation is almost very good, but you have touched the adjacent teeth. By the way, if you do an exam and you've touched adjacent teeth, they will fail you, no matter how good your preparation is, because this is iatrogenic trauma. You're creating trauma for teeth that don't have any problem in them. And once you remove the enamel thickness, that means caries will be more prominent in that area. Okay? So this is my critique for you. We're going to show you a video later on how to protect adjacent teeth. We're going to talk about that separately.